of the absurd as club ownership and name changes are allowed right bang in the middle of the season in the NPFL. Barcelona steamrolled Dortmund to ease the knockout round of the UEFA Champions League on a milestone night for Lionel Messi, and his 9th straight win for Lakers in the NBA as Anthony Davis goes back to haunt his old club. My name is Dejo Motoimbo. Welcome to Sports Express. For today's edition of Sports Express, brought to you by us, Sport Vision. We start with international newsreel. Here is Pedro Peter.
Thank you, DJ. First story is from boxing, where British heavyweight Dillian White will face Polish counterpart Mariusz Wap on the undercard of the Anthony Joshua vs. Andy Ruiz Jr. rematch bout in Riyadh, Saudi Arabia next month. The 31-year-old who defeated Oscar Rivas in July has not fought since it emerged that he failed the UK anti-doping drugs test, though he has not faced any sanctions for the adverse result. White is confident that he will be victorious on the night and has not ruled out the chance of landing a world title in 2020. From boxing, we head over to athletics, where the United States Anti-Doping Agency, USADA, has called for the World Anti-Doping Agency, WADA, to get tougher and sanction all Russian athletes from participating at the Olympics. The IWF has halted Russia's reinstatement after senior officials were suspended for anti-doping rule breaches, and USADA chief Travis Tagat insists WADA must impose the full ban on Russian athletes as the rules allow. WADA's executive committee will consider the recommendations and make a final decision at a meeting in Paris on December the 9th. Lastly, we drive off to Formula One, where Team Mercedes have revealed that they will head into the season-ending Abu Dhabi Grand Prix this weekend with a point to prove. Team boss Toto Wolff, who was absent at the Brazilian Grand Prix in Sao Paulo, insists the overall performance was disappointing due to self-inflicted mistakes. Mercedes have already sealed a 6th consecutive Constructors' Championship title.
Thank you very much, Pedro Peter. But even though he's here, not a great time to be a fan of the Spurs, it has to be said. But these Spurs, action from overnight matches, Minnesota 113, San Antonio 101. San Antonio have lost 10 of the last 11 and 5 straight at home. We'll get to that in a minute. Rockets over the Heat 117-108. Harden 34 points. Wizards over Phoenix 140-132. Clippers defeated Grizzlies 121-119. Milwaukee Bucks got the better of Hawks 111-102. Giannis 30 points and 10 rebounds. Orlando Magic cast a spell on Cleveland 116-104. Raptors defeated New York Knicks 126-98. Pascal Siakam 31 points. Hornets stung Pistons 1-point victory 102-101. Philadelphia over Sacramento 97-91. Embiid 33 points and 16 rebounds after his duck in the previous game. Celtics 121, Nets 110. Indiana Pacers 121, Utah Jazz 102, and the Lakers are rolling. Showtime is back in LA. 9th straight win. LA Lakers defeated New Orleans Pelicans 114-110, and Anthony Davis haunted his old club. Season high, I think, 41 points.
You know, there are a lot of Lakers fans
around you.
Yes. Yes. So they are believing. Both internal and external.
Okay.
Some are listening.
So I would.
Please, let's move on to. they harassed me enough.
I actually did an article last night, yeah, and I tagged it. Can LeBron lead the Lakers back to the promised land?
They can.
So let me ask you the question.
Yeah, they can. It depends on if they're injury free.
Okay.
Because I don't think LeBron can do it without Anthony Davis.
Anthony Davis,
you know, he gets injured at most inappropriate of times.
Mm-hmm.
If they manage the slot well, and I think they should, and if the goal is to own the championship, we should give him some of. Now they are playing well, they are rolling. The hard times will come. And the playoffs will be brutal. You know, you play games back to back to back.
Yeah.
And you know, all the way to the finals, they're going to have to rest him some. But if they are healthy and they are fit, if they get out of the West, because that's the key thing.
That's the key thing, yeah.
They better get out of that West.
And they have wild, to wild
the,
West.
The Mavericks, the Rockets, and the Clippers. Once they can do that,
and
the finals.
It's amazing we're talking about the West, and there's no mention of Golden State Warriors. Just in one short season.
No,
incredible.
No Warriors, no Spurs.
Okay. All right, that's it. On the International Newsroom, we return shortly with the Nigerian Sports Inc. It's a Nigerian Sports Scene on Sports X-Rays. Buddy Ogutu is still here. Just where you think you have seen it all, then stranger things happen. I honestly don't. Maybe you can throw more light, or maybe somebody I don't understand what is going on. Kwara United have taken over Delta, the same Delta that took over Kada Stars last season. So in practically 12 months.
In the calendar year.
In the calendar year, one team has had Kada Stars to Delta to Kwara, maybe to be Remo United the next time. I don't get this. And when these things happen, is it that you inherit the players as assets? Is it that you bring your own set of players? It's really confusing and right bang in the middle of the season.
Honestly, for me, when Amadu talks about
global best practice, exactly. Let him start at home.
I think he picks and chooses
when to
bang that board around. Because I don't think there's any other league in the world where a team is taken over the middle of the season and the team just moves base from Kaduna to Wari or to Sapele and then to Ilorin.
Because buddy, like you said, some people have made travel. I don't know whether they do that, but you would have probably have made your hotel bookings and your travel arrangements way ahead because you think you're going to Wari. Now, suddenly, you have to go to
Ilorin. You know, apart from the nightmare of the logistics, I think the LFC will need to educate the public. Because when was I talking about the banana league how do you explain this to sponsors? How do you explain what is going on when you don't have rules? Or when you have rules you don't enforce, or you have rules that nobody understands? Because for me, look, we just woke up and we just had the announcement. Delta Stars are not crying, explanations.
So what it means is that if I have enough money, I can just go over to a Premier League side,
that are willing to sell.
Willing to sell, name it, and then Ayodele United, Premier League club.
Hallelujah. That's what it is. That's what it is. I think the LMC they need to jump ahead of this. They need to beyond the photo ops of the jerseys and the certificates being given to Kwara. They need to tell us what actually went down. Because
and then what financial details, we deserve to know. It's ridiculous.
We need to know.
The people on the Trabzon beat, I feel sorry for you. Because you have to explain.
It is you I will ask. When I get the explanation, I will explain.
Please, it is you I will continue. We will continue to ask you until you get the proper explanation of this one. But then let's go to the Tigress. They have their groupings for the Olympic qualifying tournament. They are tagged with USA, Serbia, Mozambique. Two teams will qualify because you said USA have already qualified.
Yes.
So two of Nigeria, Serbia, and Mozambique will go through.
The
what are our chances?
The chances are good because the Tigers are the best in Africa. The best in Mozambique, they are good because for them to defeat Senegal means that they have a bit of game. But I think I like what FIBA have done because we're putting two African teams in the same group where at least one of them qualifies, an African team at the Olympics. Mm-hmm. Because if they've been in different groups, both of them will crash out. But in the same group, one of them, because only one team will go home. But from where I'm standing, the Americans will go. The Americans have qualified already, and they probably defeat the Chinese. Serbia are playing at home, so they also have the chance, home support and basketball calls, they might also get the next slot. So the game is a shootout between Nigeria
and Mozambique. Whoever loses that game goes home.
So I don't want us to play that game first. Okay. Let it be the second or third game because first game
anything can happen.
But let's play the Americans or the Serbians first.
Okay. And get into the group.
Bring them. Okay. When they bring them, I'm sure we'll beat them.
Okay.
So you can say
it will be great to have both our teams. Both our male and female teams.
It will be awesome. The other team sport that gets attention is football, and there are no football teams.
There are no football teams.
So you force to focus on basketball, and that can only be good.
Thank you very much, buddy. Detailed as always. We return with World Soccer Report next on Sports Express.